This is the Tapo app for the TP-Link Tapo C110 home Wi-Fi security camera. As you can see, I have several other Tapo cameras on this page. So this is gonna be your dashboard. You're gonna see all of your cameras here. One thing that I will mention is that the Tapo names for the cameras doesn't do that during installation of them. You have to name them after the fact. And there's no part during the actual setup process that allows you to name them. You have to go in afterwards. One thing that I wish they would do a little differently with that. Over here, you can see I have three cameras listed, and then it will show you the last little snippet that it grabbed from each of the cameras. Over here, we have an envelope with a dot. We'll let you know if Tapo has found somebody. Selecting the notification will allow you to take a screenshot, turn on and off the volume, but also, more importantly, download, which will add it to your memories. So if Tapo automatically detects somebody and sends you a notification about it, you can download it rather than having to do the other steps that we'll talk about later. And if we need to add a new camera, we simply come up here to the little circle with the plus sign and select that, and we can add a camera. But we are going to go into our indoor camera right here. This is our non-pan tilt camera. Currently it is set up in my kitchen to keep track of my cats, so we might see them pop in there as we start talking. Right here we can see a live feed. Selecting auto right there will allow me to change from day mode to night mode, so I can swap that over and it will change it over to night mode and turn on the IR lights, and we can set it back to auto, so that'll be based on the actual available lighting, and that'll take a moment to change back, but there we go. In the lower left-hand corner, we see a grid. If we select the grid and you have multiple Tapo cameras, you will be able to pick up and see all of your cameras. This is a live feed. These are all happening right now. I wish a cat or a car would go by, but we can add another camera if we had one to the grid simply by selecting it from our list over here. If we had more, I'm gonna go back to my single view, because you can also have all of your Tapo cameras available from within one of the camera views. So that's my living room, and then this will be my outdoor view, all available in one location. I really like that about the Tapo app. Moving on, we have the snapshot icon. Selecting that will take a screenshot of what it sees. We have our record feature, which I will get to another location that talks about that, but that will record what is happening live right there. And you've got your mute, or in my case, I have a camera's microphone completely turned off. And then this right here, your view will automatically change if you tilt your phone, but you can also force it to do so by selecting there. And you will notice right down there, all of those icons we had previously are located within that section when we flip it. Coming down, we have our talk. Selecting this will allow us to connect to our camera, and then we press and hold and start talking. Now, we might see a cat run into frame as they're looking for food. Within this area, we have a toggle which will allow us to adjust the camera's microphone and the camera speaker independently of each other, right there. Really nice that's there. Selecting the dropdown pushes that back down. We have voice call. So this is a little different than the quick talk. This is actually like you are setting up a call between you and the camera. We're gonna hang that up because we don't want that going on. Privacy mode, as you might expect, it is to initiate privacy mode. Selecting that, there is nothing that rolls up on this camera. No shutter that comes down. It just throws up a message letting you know that privacy mode has been enabled and you will not be able to see a live feed through this, or you will not get any notifications, recordings, or anything while this is on. I have tested this. Even though it doesn't do anything physically to the device, it does not record. My recommendation is once we get up to the settings that you leave the status light on, because the status light will turn itself off when it's in privacy mode. Right here we have our alarm. Selecting that will sound an alarm. And again, trying not to freak my cats out, but that will set an alarm off for the camera itself. Tapo Care, we're gonna skip for a moment, but we'll get back to it. And we're gonna come over to our playback and memories. So playback and memories is just that. If you have an SD card, which you should, and there we go. That is the last detected motion you can see right there. That is a cat coming into frame. One of the things I like about the playbacks, right up here, if we select R1, we can actually go all the way up to 16 speed, but we can also drop it down to 1/16 speed. So you've always seen cameras that can speed things up, but this will actually allow you to slow it down. Right down here, we have our activity timeline. If I select one, you'll notice down here on this timeline, they're all orange. Well, orange indicates motion. Green would indicate a person. You can zoom in and see your timeline. Now, because I happen to have this off when I'm actually around, you're not going to see me or any green, but just know this is a really cool timeline. Lets you see visually what's going on. Selecting back will bring you to the previous day, or selecting the middle will allow you to pick a specified day. Notice the numbers in black don't have any information. The numbers in blue do. And there you see a cat walking. I'm going to select back one more time and then back into our playback and memory. So that was our playback feature. These are the recorded clips that it captured. If we come over to our memories, this is going to be any recordings that you manually do. And when I say manually do, these clips right here, notice they're playing here. They're not downloadable. So what you would actually have to do is select the record button and it will create a recording of what you're visually seeing off of that memory on the SD card. Once you hit stop, then that actually gets saved to the memories location, which would then allow you to click in and then download it to your device. This is the one thing about the Tapo app I wish they would do a little better. It just feels like you have to jump through way too many hoops in order to actually download a clip that you might have gotten. Right here, this is Tapo Care. This is going to give us access to, one, the monthly subscription if you want to. You don't need it. However, if you choose to have the monthly subscription, you can see one device will be about $350, two devices. They also have a yearly plan. With Tapo Care, you have access to unlimited cloud storage for 30 days, because it'll do rollover, exclusive AI detection, so not just person, but you get baby detection, rich notifications, which is important because right now, if you don't have Tapo Care, the notification that you get is just a text message. You won't see anything. It's just something happened, something happened, something happened. Moving on, custom privacy zones. Again, that's something that only with the Tapo Care subscription you can do. We'll touch on that in a moment. And then motion tracking. This particular camera cannot do motion tracking, but if you have their pan camera, you will only have motion tracking, meaning it'll follow a target if you have the Tapo Care subscription. Now, speaking of the subscription, down here, we actually have our cloud video storage. So selecting this, just like we had the clips before, well, they also are currently being saved to the cloud. Notice from the cloud though, we can download right away. We can edit this and we can delete it. We can also take a snapshot. Backing off, that is our cloud selection if you pay for the Tapo Care. That's all of our controls that we can do for the indoor camera. But there's a lot more that we can do because, well, if we come up here and select the cog for settings, this is a lot of stuff that we can alter. Right here, this is going to be how you need to change the name so that it doesn't say Tapo Camera, especially if you have multiple Tapo cameras. Coming down, we have our icon location. Well, we can select, hey, this is in here, and it will allow us to change the visual icon so we can visually see where it is to make it a little easier for ourselves. Time zone, as you might imagine, time zone. Tapo Care, I'm currently working on the free trial of this, but it would tell you right here if you want, need to purchase it. You can purchase it right through here, or I can cancel my subscription. Chances are you will also see any fees for that listed there. Invert image, if you have your camera mounted upside down, you want the image to be correct, you select invert image. Status LED, as I talked about, you do want to keep this on, especially if you're going to be utilizing the privacy mode. You want to know when that camera is not paying attention to you. Privacy zones, again, only available if you have Tapo Care. So that's that paid subscription. When enabled, custom privacy zones cannot be viewed or monitored to protect your privacy. So selecting that, hypothetically, I would go privacy zone, add a zone. I would say this over here, this door is a privacy zone. Don't do that. And then I would save. So right there, look at that. It is blacked out from the recording. That's pretty cool that you can do that. But again, only available if you pay for the subscription. It's a nice ad for the subscription, realistically. Coming down, we have our detections and alerts. Right here, I have motion detection and AI detection. Well, if I turn on AI detection, I can do person detection, turn that on. Coming down, crying baby. Well, I don't have a crying baby, so I don't have to worry about that, but this is where you would change that selection. Down here, activity notification. So yes, I want to get activity notifications. Yes, I want that rich notification, which will give you that little thumbnail. And then send notifications. I want it all the time, but if you select custom, you can actually create yourself a schedule, days and specific times, if you need them only during specific times. And then camera alarm, this is where you can toggle it off so it sends alert and will allow you to, if I turn that on, hey, alarm type? Do you want sound and light? Do you want light? Do you want sound? So a way to make this kind of like a little mini burglar alarm system. Alarm sound coming in here, you have siren or tone, and then when do you want this? All day or just like before, you can schedule specific days and times that you would like that to run. I'm just gonna leave that on all, and I'm gonna turn that back off. And that was our detection and alerts. Micro SD card, again, this is really good because it has onboard storage. You have, in my case, I have a 64 gigabyte card in there, and it's letting me know, hey, everything's good. You might have to format the card when you first put it in. Right now I have it on loop recording, meaning that the oldest items will get written over as new items come about. But if you don't want that, you can select off, and then you can swap out the SD card so that you keep any data that's on there. It's nice that that's there. It's an interesting feature I don't see on a lot of other cameras. And then we have our micro SD card recording. You can toggle that on and off. And then you have your recording schedule. Well, you can come in here. What would you like to record? Well, right now it's detection recording. But if I select edit up here, I can say, hey, do continuous recording, or I can clear. But that's how you can schedule recordings. Moving down, we have our video quality. Right now I have it on the 1080p, but you can go down to 720p, which is still considered HD, or you can bring it up to the 3MP, which is going to be your more, as they show you here. Hey, you can zoom in, you can see a lot more. Keep in mind that using the 3MP will actually use up a lot more bandwidth if you're doing live feed. Coming down to advanced settings, well, here we go. We have our camera account. You can create an account just specifically for this one camera. You have record audio. Do you want that on or off? I obviously want that on, but depending on where you are, you might need to turn that off. On-screen display settings. Well, what does that mean? Here we have our display time and date, and then our time date stamp. How do we want that? It's gonna show like that. Display text, what would you like to display on that? Well, right now it says TCP IP, but you can have your own wording displayed on the camera. And then display logo is the little Tapo watermark if you want that on there. Privacy mode, on or off. This is another place that we can toggle that. And then power line frequency, you can have it at auto or manually adjust to 50 or 60 hertz. Recommended that you leave it on auto if you don't know what you're doing. And then diagnostics, do you want to give TP-Link diagnostic information from your camera? And then down here we have shared devices. You can share this device with somebody else who has their own Tapo app. So this won't work if they have the TP Casa app. They need their own TP Tapo app in order for you to share with them. But that's how you'd be able to share your device, which will allow them to see your feed. And then auto reboot. Well, sometimes, you know, you need your camera to automatically reboot. Sometimes you have to do that to your Wi-Fi router. You can set that up automatically, specifying, yes, I would like that, and then a time frame, and then it will automatically restart your camera. We can manually reboot the camera right now, or we can remove the camera from our Tapo app. And that has been all of the settings for the indoor camera, as well as the controls. We're gonna come back to the main page really quickly to show you some of these icons on the bottom. We are currently on the home tab for all of this. If we come over to Smart Actions, there's a lot of things that you can set up if you're in their ecosystem. Right now, I'm just testing out their cameras, but if you had lighting and locks, you can do a lot of things here. So like, leave home. You can actually set up, hey, turn my cameras on when I'm not home. That's all done through here. Shortcuts, automations, again, there's a lot of extra things built into the app that you can do from this screen, and it's a nice addition. Coming down, we have our accounts area, which moves the email address slightly off screen up here, but you have your camera memory, shows you all the things that are on here, but that's all of your cameras, account-wide. Same thing with your cloud video. Here you can pick your individual camera. Camera memory is gonna be everything. Third-party services, and then device sharing, kind of self-explanatory there. Firmware, I can come in here, check firmware for my particular camera. There's nothing. I can do notifications. Do I want promotional notifications from TP-Link and Tapo? Do I want firmware notifications? Do I want micro SD card status notifications? And then Tapo device status. This one, you can only do your single, but you can come in here and select all of them. Tapo device status, again, more notifications that you can get. We have our Tapo Care. Again, that's gonna bring us to that area that we were before where we can sign up for the monthly subscription if we haven't done that already. We have our camera preferences, which again, this is kind of nice. Do you want live tagging? Right there, shows you live. Or do we want speed? I like how they kind of show you on this image where those would be if you want them on your camera. Vibration, do you want that on and off? Again, based on notifications, do you want vibration letting you know, hey, you got a notification. Help and feedback, well, as it sounds, do you need help and feedback? select your device, and it will bring you, hey, here's some help, or you can send them feedback. I always appreciate when they build those into the application rather than having go online and search down an email address. And then about, gonna have some sensitive information about my particular camera. Not gonna show that, but coming back to our homepage here, that was all the areas within the Tapo app that you can do with the Tapo indoor